In this session, let us go for a problem solve, a numerical problem solve on this RISC architecture. So, numerical problems used to come in the GATE and also in the semester exams on this particular RISC architecture, and the problems are somewhat alike to this particular problem. So that's why if you can solve this one and if you can understand what we are doing in this particular problem, you can solve most of the problems on RISC architecture. So let me go for that. Let me read the problem at first. A RISC architecture consists of 74 registers. Okay, so that means the number of registers will be ranging from R0 to R73. Okay, so I'm writing this one. So I'm writing in this way: large register file size is equal to 74. That means R73 to R0 registers. This much we have got information. Suggest suitable values for global, local, and common registers. Suggest suitable values for global, local, and common registers. Another important point, it has been mentioned that 74 registers divided into 4 overlapping windows. So that is very important. So number of window W is equal to 4. Question is coming in mind, what is the meaning of the term window and what is the meaning of this global, local, and common registers? Also calculate window size for the proposed architecture. So there is a total question. So how to solve such questions? Window size 4 means we will be having 4 modules. That is confirmed. Let the modules names are, so we are having 4 modules. Let the modules names are A, B, C, D for their identification. Okay, you can give other modules name also, no issues. So window size 4 means 4 modules will be there. And these 4 modules, in my earlier video, I think you have checked that each and every module has got, one is the parameter registers, local registers, and the temporary registers. It will be coming like this. So now I've drawn this one. There is a very, very rough sketch of the architecture. So how many modules are there? 4 modules. So I shall keep some registers as the global registers, which will be accessible by all the modules. Okay. A register will have some local register. A module will have some local register. And similarly for D, B, and C. And these registers are common between A and D. To pass parameters from A to D, then A will be treating this one as the temporary, and D will be treating this one as the parameter register. If D wants to send some information to A, then D will treat this particular registers as the temporary, and A will be treating this one as the parameter registers. So that means these registers are common between A and D. So that is final. Common between AB, common between BC, common between CD, DAB, these are the things. So in this way, the architecture will work. In some books, the same diagram they have drawn in a circular fashion. But if you want to draw that one in a circular fashion, it might be tricky during your exams. So that's why it is better to go for this rectangular diagram. Okay, now in this way it is working. But I think for the module window size 4, so that's why the diagram has become rectangular. It's easy to draw. But when the window size will be 7 or 8, then obviously you should have to think about that. So now see, we will be having local registers. Local registers means these registers are local. Sorry, these registers are local. These are the local registers. And these registers are the common. These registers are the common. And we shall be having some global registers. So these are the local, let me tell you. These are the local registers. These are the common registers. And this is a global, already it has been written. This is a global registers. So now you see all these registers, the sum of all these registers will be 74. So that is the problem. Now how to divide these registers? I'm going to tell you. Let us suppose for the global registers, I'm keeping 10 registers. For the global registers, I'm keeping 10 registers. Now, how many local registers? How many local registers? 4 number of. How many number of common registers? 4 number of. So how many registers are left? So 74 minus 10 is equal to 64. 64 by, say I'm going for say by 4, then we are getting 16. So I'm just dividing them as 6 and 10. 16 will be divided as 6 and 10. So that will be the total division. So 6, 10, 6, 10, 6, 10, 6, 10, and this is my 10. So in total, I shall be getting 74. So what will be the large register file size? That means global registers plus window times, local registers and common registers. So global registers plus window, number of window times local plus common, because we are having 4 local and 4 common because the window was 4. So that's why it is nothing but 10 plus 4 into, if I do the back calculation, so 10 plus 6, so obviously you are going to get 74. And this is known as large register file size calculation formula. So I've written this one. I've written this one here. Large register file size. So W into L plus C plus G. Please remember this formula. It will be required for other numerical problems. Okay, next. Now tell me, a single module can access how many registers? A single module can access how many registers? A single module can access L registers local to itself. So both side 2 common registers and obviously global register. And this is known as the window size. This is known as the window size. So also calculate the window size. Also calculate the window size of your proposed architecture. So what will be the value then? So local means 10 plus 2 into common plus global. So what is the size? 20, and this is my 12. So that is the 20 plus 12. So that is the 32. 32 is my window size. So what is the formula? L plus 2 into C plus G. I have written the same. Window size is equal to L plus 2 into C plus G. So I have discussed these two very important formula required for most of the numerical problems. Now let me show you the register mapping. 10 registers for the global, R0 to R9, common to all processors, and then we are having this global, it will be known as the global registers. Okay, so I am making this one common to all windows, that will be better, because in the questions it has been mentioned as windows. Okay, now, so R0 to R9, so A to D, how many of them common? 6. Then 10 to local A, then 6 to local B and A, 6 to common to B and A, then 10 to local B, 10 registers for local B, and then 6 registers common to C and B, then 10 registers local to C, 48 to 57, if you go on counting it is 10, and then common between D and C, how many registers? 58 to 63. 58, 59, 52, 50, 60, 61, 62, I'm not getting, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63. So obviously we are having the 6 registers common. So now again local to D, intentionally I've written this one twice, intentionally I've written this one twice only to indicate that it is circular, only to indicate that it is circular. So that's why this particular combination I've written here again. What is the starting register number? R0. What is the maximum register number? R73. Did you plan accordingly? Yes, I planned accordingly. So that is the register mapping. So this is the problem. So what will be the large register file size? G plus, it is written there, G plus W into L plus C. Let me check. G plus W into L plus C. What is the window size? L plus 2 times C plus G. Let me check. L plus 2 times C plus G. So that is the window size. So in this way, I've done this formula. I've done this problem.
Don't you have some other combinations are you thinking about? You can do so. But try to keep, always try to keep, number of local registers must be greater than equal to common registers. Please maintain this one, because we require more variables in our modules, local variables in our modules, and few arguments we pass to the other functions for calling, other modules to call. So that's why it is better, it is our suggestion is that keep more than that means the local registers number should be more than equal to the common registers number. I have kept that one. So local registers I have kept 10 and common registers I have kept 6, and this is the global registers. I have done each and every calculation into details. So please follow my steps, and this is the register mapping. So how to draw this one, I have shown you that one. So I think your conception has got cleared. So I think you have got the logic. Thanks for watching.